Hey, this is Presh Talwalkar. A marshmallow has the shape of a cylinder. It has a diameter of 5 and a height of 3. A dessert is made with 24 marshmallows. The bottom layer consists of 3 rows of 4 marshmallows. A top layer consists of exactly the same arrangement. Marshmallows are placed on top of the bottom layer. The dessert is completed when chocolate is poured to exactly fill the gaps between the marshmallows. This is a side view of the dessert. Here's a top view of the dessert. Chocolate exactly fills the gaps between the marshmallows. The question is, what is the volume of chocolate? This problem was asked to grade 12 students in Australia. Can you figure it out? Give this problem a try, and when you're ready, keep watching the video for the solution. The main principle is that the volume of the chocolate is equal to the area of a cross-section of chocolate times the height of chocolate. The dessert consists of 2 layers of marshmallows, each which have a height of 3. The total height of the chocolate will therefore be 6. So the volume is equal to the area of a single cross-section times 6. We can see the cross-section from the top view. This forms the shape of 6 different gaps between the marshmallows. Each of the 6 gaps are identical. We therefore can simplify this to say the volume is equal to 6 times the area of a single gap, multiplied by the height of 6. So the volume is equal to 36 times the area of the single gap between 4 marshmallows. What is that area? We start out by having 4 marshmallows. Each marshmallow has a diameter of 5, which means each circle has a radius of 5 halves. We now draw a square that connects the center of these 4 circles. The square side length consists of the radius of 2 adjacent circles. The side length of the square is therefore equal to the diameter of the circle, so the side length is equal to 5. The area between the gaps is equal to the area of this square minus the area of 4 quarter circles. So we can write this as the area of the gap is equal to the area of the square minus the area of 4 quarter circles. Now 4 quarter circles together make 1 whole circle. The area of the square is equal to s squared, and the area of the circle is equal to pi r squared. This means the area of the square is equal to 25, and the area of the circle is equal to 25 pi divided by 4. Therefore, the area of the gap is equal to the difference between these two areas. We can substitute this back into our volume formula and then simplify to get our answer that the volume is equal to 900 minus 225 pi, which is approximately 193.1. Did you figure it out? Thanks for watching this video. Please subscribe to my channel. I make videos on math and game theory. You can catch me on my blog, Mind Your Decisions, which you can follow on Facebook, Google+, and Patreon. You can catch me on social media at Presh Talwalkar. And if you like this video, please check out my books. There are links in the video description.